But this time, we have an all-star lineup of developers, translators, and field testers here on stage with us for a very special developer Q&A on Pokemon Go. From the Pokemon Company, we have with us today Mr. Ishihara.
Hi. Thank you.
From Game Freak, we have Mr. Masuda.
Hi.
From Niantic, we have Mr. Nomura. Of course, from Nintendo, we have Mr. Miyamoto himself. Supporting us with translation today, we have David Numrich from the Pokemon Company International, and our good friend Raymond, who many of you saw on stream yesterday from Nintendo, translating. And then we have two representatives of the community of field testers who have been field testing Pokemon Go. We've got Josh Jaywitz Wittenkeller and Aaron Cybertron Jang.
Hey guys.
Now, for those of you who aren't familiar with Pokemon Go, and I'm sure there's not too many of you, but Pokemon Go is a new application coming for smart devices that allows you to capture and battle Pokemon in real life using location data on your phone. Obviously, there's been excitement building for the launch of Pokemon Go ever since the original announcement. And of course, building towards the field testing that has now started around the world in different countries, Japan, the US, and Australia. But one of the big surprises that came out of the original announcement of Pokemon Go was the collaboration between the three key companies of the Pokemon Company, Niantic, and Nintendo. So, Mr. Ishihara, I was wondering if perhaps you could maybe talk a little bit about the reaction to the announcement and what the reactions have been with the launch of the field tests as well.
まあ、去年発表されてから、はい、まあ、すごく期待が高まっている状況ではあると思うんですけども、フィールドテストも、はい、いろんな国で始まって、はい、まあ、特にその発表会で、まあ、多分ファンの皆さんがすごくびっくりしたのは、その任天堂、ナイアンティック、ポケモンの3社のコラボレーションというところもあったと思うんですけれども、はい、まあ、発表してからの、なんていうんですかね、その世の中の反響というものっていうのはいかがでしょうか。はい、
まずまあ、フィールドテスターの募集をしたときにものすごい反響があったので、すごい手応えをまず感じましたね。
So I'm definitely feeling a really positive reaction. When we began the field test signups, we just had so many people signing up, so very pleased to see that.
まあ、本当にフィールドテスターの皆さんには素晴らしい意見や素晴らしいデータをたくさん提供いただきましたので、今日ここでまずありがとうと言いたいです。
And to all the field testers, I mean, we've been getting a lot of amazing feedback. We've been able to gather a lot of data based on their gameplay. So I really just want to say thanks to everyone who's been helping with the test.
で、そのフィールドテスターの代表として今日、ジョシュさんとアーロンさんが来ていただいてますので、まあ、彼らからいろんな意見や質問をぶつけていただきたいと思っています。
And as two representatives of that field testing community, we have Josh and Aaron here today. And I hope to, they'll ask me a bunch of questions and maybe give me some of their candid opinions as well.
もともとこのポケモン GO のプロジェクトは、その2013年の、Google のエイプリルフールのポケモンチャレンジ、それはこちらの野村さんが仕掛けて考えたものなんですけど、そこから始まっていますので、まあ、その辺の話も少しね、野村さんの方からも話していただければと思います。
And this project really got its start back in 2013 when we did an April Fool's project with Google, the Pokemon Challenge. And actually, Mr. Tatsuo Nomura right here, he's at Niantic now, was kind of at the center of that project. And I think we'll be able to hear more about it from him.
So yeah, Nomura-san, you started work on it as an April Fool's project. Can you talk about that and how development's going so far?
Yeah, absolutely. So Pokemon Challenge, the video was just showing up there. You can actually find me in there. Yeah, it was one of the April Fool's Day joke that I was worked on when I was back in Google Maps team. And that Pokemon Challenge got me connected with Mr. Ishihara here and John Hankey, a CEO at Niantic. Who started this real-world gaming genre with Ingress. And so John and Ishihara-san and myself, we all met, and then we basically agreed that this is a great opportunity. We can bring Pokemon into the real world. It was really exciting. I'm really happy to see how it turned out to a real project. And we already started field test in Australia, New Zealand, and Japan, and US. So there are more than thousands, I mean, tens of thousands of players are actually playing it. In fact, I think the last time I checked, there were 30 Pokeballs thrown per second. So if you think about it, that's really amazing.
Now, Mr. Miyamoto, of course, there's a peripheral device that is going to be associated with Pokemon Go called Pokemon Go Plus, and we're going to ask you some questions about that a little bit later. But I was wondering if there was anything you could add about the partnership between Nintendo and Niantic and Pokemon and how that got started?
Pokemon Go とつながるこの Pokemon Go Plus というデバイスがあるんですけれども、まあ、それについてちょっと後ほどお話を伺いたいと思うんですけれども、その前にもしやこの3社のこの関係、協力関係というのについて何かこう話していただける内容がありましたら。
本当に実はこれね、岩田さんが石原さんと進めたということで、で僕ももともとポケモンに関係があるものですから、今日はここで皆さんにね ご説明一緒にできることが非常に楽しみにしてました。
So actually this is something that Mr. Iwata and Mr. Ishihara had started working on and I was also involved, so I'm very excited to be here to share this with all of you.
Thank you. So we have a number of key phrases or topics that we kind of want to hit on today, and one of those is real-world gaming. And real-world gaming is something I think that obviously Niantic pioneered with their game Ingress. It uses the location-based data in your phone. And in the case of Pokemon Go, what it does is it allows you to go out and find Pokemon in the real world, find ways to capture them, you know, and battle them. It's really kind of impressive. I've been actually fortunate enough to be a part of the beta test or the field testing myself, and having a lot of fun catching Pokemon and playing. Mr. Ishihara, obviously we've had a lot of people around the world are now a part of the field test, and we're seeing a lot of reaction from them. But I'm actually interested in how you're playing Pokemon Go in your everyday life.
まずはまあ、ナイアンティック社が、開いたジャンルの、リアルワールドゲームですね。位置情報を使って、まあ、ゲームをする、ジャンルになるんですけれども、まあ今回のポケモン GO の場合はこう外に出てポケモンを捕まえるというものだと思うんですけれども、自分も、フィールドテスターとして参加させてもらっていてすごく非常に楽しんでるんですけれども、はいはい、石田さんとしてはどういう遊び方をされているんでしょうか。
そうですね、まあ、こちらのフィールドテスターの皆さん特に、まあポケモンを実際の空間で捕まえるという体験をされていると思いますけれども、私自身もフィールドテスターとして、私自身はかなり優秀なフィールドテスターだと思っているんですけれども、毎朝愛犬と一緒にですね、フィールドテストしてます。あそこに少し映ってますけれども、
So I think everyone here has been playing in the field test and really enjoying going out into the real world, catching Pokemon in the familiar spaces that around their neighborhoods and such. But I'm also a very diligent field tester myself. I think I have provided a lot of good feedback. And here's some pictures of my morning walks with my dog and I've been catching Pokemon.
I love these pictures of your dog. He looks very nervous with the Pokemon there in the picture with
これ写真すごいですね。やっぱこれワンちゃんちょっと緊張してるんじゃないですか、ポケモンの前で。
あ、ちなみに愛犬の名前はポキと言います。
So, yeah, my dog's name is Poki, actually.
はい。彼と毎朝
I also have been doing a lot of field testing while walking my dog. And I find that if my dog is in the viewfinder, it seems to me like it's easier for me to catch the Pokemon. Is this true or am I crazy?
自分は犬の散歩を毎朝してるんですけれども、そのポケモンを捕まえるときに、ワンちゃんが映ってると、なんかこう捕まえやすく、なるような感じも自分は思うんですけれども、そういうなんかプログラミングっていうのは。
犬のさん、そんなすごいテクノロジー入ってますか？
それ、ジュパターからさ、ゲーム
する
のか？いや、AI を使って、優秀なもの。
気のせいですか？
気のせいですね。
No, it's probably just your imagination.
あと実際にね、私もこのロサンゼルスでたくさんポケモンを捕まえたりしてきましたので。
And I've actually caught a few Pokemon here in Los Angeles.
こんな感じですね。会場でミャオス。
This is here in the convention center.
入り口ですね。
Right at the entrance to E3.
こんな感じですね。はい。で昨日はこのサンムーンの会場で、マチョップが出てきました。
This was during the Treehouse Live segment for Pokemon Sun and Moon.
、はい、でゲームの方はですね、
so in the actual game itself,
こんな感じで、結構強いポケモンまで育て上げております。
So I've actually got quite a few really strong Pokemon.
捕まえた場所は千代田区東京ジャパンだったり。
And you can see that all the location of where I caught it, 千代田 and Tokyo.
はい、 ロサンゼルスで捕まえたミャオス。
Here's the Meowth that I caught here in LA.
EV ですね。
An EV.
ロサンゼルス。はい。もう毎日あの素晴らしいフィールドテスターになっていますね。
So I think I'm a pretty good field tester. I'm playing it, you know, quite a bit every day.
I can prove that.
Yeah, I find that I'm walking a lot more than I used to because of the field testing. So thank you.
まあフィールドテストのおかげでいつも以上にちょっと歩いてるっていうことになってます。ありがとうございます。
Now, Josh, you've been playing a lot as well. Do you have any pictures you want to share or any questions you want to ask?
Yeah. So I've been playing a lot, especially around my new home and workplace, over the ferry and in the city of San Francisco.Which is actually not super far from where Niantic is. So I've been able to see a lot of Pokemon. I've caught a couple hundred, and I love that I'm still able to give them nicknames, which has been a lot of fun. But I have noticed that I've seen the same core of around 50 or so specific types of Pokemon. So I guess if I had a question, it would be, where can you find other types of Pokemon? Like if you're traveling to differentcountries or areas, and also I've only seen Kanto Pokemon. Are there plans to have Pokemon outside of Kanto as well?
まあ、ジョッシュの方はあの最近サンフランシスコに引っ越してあのフィールドテストをそこでも中心的にやってるんですけれども、まあ、あの100匹以上のポケモンを捕まえて、通勤の時とかは捕まえてるんですけれども、大体同じこう50種類ぐらいの、ポケモンを、見かける、ことに、ね、今なっています。でちょっと2つ質問があるんですけれども、まあ、他の場所に行けばやっぱ違う種類のポケモンが、出るのか、要は他の実際の地球の場所に行くと、もう1つがあの、まあ、今ちょっと関東地方の、最初の、赤緑の、ポケモンしかちょっと見かけてないんですけれども、他の地方のポケモンも出てくるんでしょうか。
はい、まずですね、その、まあ、ポケモンの基本はあの全部捕まえようと、ガラキャッチモールですから、すべてのポケモンが捕まえられるようにしようと思っています。
So obviously with Pokemon you have the slogan Gotta catch them all, and really completing your Pokedex is kind of part of the fun of Pokemon, so we want to bring the game to a point where eventually you can catch all of them.
ただ、まあ、今年はポケモン20周年ですので、この一番最初の20年前の赤緑の、ポケモンをまずみんなで捕まえてもらいたいと思っています。
But being the 20th anniversary of Pokemon, we feel that it was appropriate to begin the game with the main Pokemon from the red and blue games.
まあ、この赤緑のポケモンはまあ、昔から遊んでいる人にとっては非常に懐かしくて、で最近遊び始めた人にとっては、まあ、意外と新鮮で珍しいという特徴があると思います。
So I think one of the cool things about the red and blue Pokemon is that they're both kind of simultaneously really nostalgic for players who began with the original entries, but also kind of fresh and maybe not so familiar to the people who've kind of joined the series with the recent entries.
なので、まあ、まずここから始めて徐々に種類が増えていくというふうにして、全部を捕まえてもらいたいと思っています。
So at the beginning we're going to launch with the red and blue Pokemon, but we're going to gradually add more and more, and eventually you'll be able to catch them all.
All right, sounds great.
あと2つ目の、まあ捕まり、どんなところにどんなポケモンがいるか、まあ、これはちょっと野村さんの方から話してもらった方がいいです。
So I think I'll actually have Tatsuo field your question about, you know, which Pokemon to where type of thing.
Right, you can play the more series. You know, you'll find water Pokemon near water, and like Rattata, grass Pokemon, and toad grass. So we are doing essentially the same, except that you have to go into the real world. You have to explore the world to discover these Pokemon. Like, so if you live in the San Francisco Bay Area, then you probably find a lot of water Pokemon there, right?
Yeah, a lot of Krabby, Horsea, Starmie, and I noticed Aaron actually does not have very many water Pokemon. So I'm definitely starting to see like some gap depending on where you are in certain areas. Mm.
So that's what we are trying to do using Niantic's location technology and try to map the Pokemon to the real world. So you need to actually explore a little further than your neighborhood to catch them all.
Aaron, have you had any questions that have popped up in your field testing?
Yeah, so this kind of actually builds off what you just said about, you know, relating to the core series, but I've been beta testing for about 3 or 4 weeks back in my city of New York, and Josh and I actually compared like the Pokemon list we had, and they're pretty similar. You know, he had some water Pokemon that I didn't have, but like you mentioned, there was like this core kind of number of Pokemon that we both saw, and there were also a bunch of Pokemon that neither of us have seen yet. So I wanted to ask, is Pokemon Go going to be like the main series where there's some Pokemon that are significantly harder and more rare to catch?
まあ、自分はニューヨークを中心にフィールドテストをやってるんですけれども、今日 まあ、ここに来てサンフランシスコのに住んでいる女子とちょっと捕まえてるポケモンを見比べたんですけども、やっぱちょっと違いが結構出てて、その地域差みたいなこともあったんですけれども、ちょっと本編シリーズみたいにやっぱこうなんていうんですかね、その捕まりにくいポケモンとか珍しいポケモンっていうのはやっぱ今回も自走してるかっていう質問になるんですけれども、
Yeah, absolutely. So, if you saw the Arbra, I saw Arbra on the video.
Yeah.
Like for example, in the core series, the Arbra runs away, right? It teleports away. So that's something we have in Pokemon Go as well. We consulted with Masuda-san, Ishihara-san to try to catch to reserve the Pokemon very nature and have wide variety of a different type, the rarer ones. Harder to catch ones, they all exist in our in the Pokemon Go as well.
Okay, thank you.
Now, obviously, Pokemon Sun and Moon are the upcoming Nintendo 3DS games, and Masuda-san, you're working on those simultaneously with Pokemon Go, which is on a smart device. So I was wondering, where are you putting your development focus on Pokemon Go, and what are the key elements for you that are most important to bring to life in the smart device?
まあ、増田さんなんですけども、まあ、ポケモンサンとムーンの開発ももちろん、まあ、同時にやってるというふうに思うんですけれども、はい、まあ、それは 3DS のゲームであって、今回スマートフォンのゲームなんですけれども、はい、今回はスマートフォンでこうポケモン GO みたいなゲームを作るにあたって、こう特にこう開発に注力されたことっていうのは、
そうですね、何でしょうか。やっぱりこう世界中のいろんなところに出てくるゲームなので、まあ、ポケモン GO にとって一番大事なのはやっぱりこう捕まえる、ポケモンを捕まえるっていうことだなと思ったので、ポケモンを捕まえるところはむちゃむちゃこだわってますね。
So I think with Pokemon Go, because we wanted to have enough Pokemon in different places in the world, we really wanted to put the focus on the catching of Pokemon. So I really, that's really why I focus most of my energy on getting that aspect right.
ちょっとさっき出してみたんですけど、
AR モード、like、
AR モードにするとですね、
you turn on AR mode, it switches to use the camera here, and here it is with us.
これ映しちゃっていいのかな、皆さん反対側に。
I'm not sure if it's okay to show everyone who's out there in line, but.
Everybody,
those are folks in line
playing Zelda. 見て多
分全部回ってるよ。
ちょっと逃げましょう一旦。ちょっと。他のやつを
ran away from that one.
こいつを捕まえてみましょう。
Let's try this one here.
いますね。ちょっとですね。これ今いろんなボールの動きとあとは的のところに
ちょっとそれ不具合が出てるのでこっちに。
ちょっとこっちに。
Looks like we're having a little issue with the. We're going to switch up the phone. But what he was just showing there is that you can kind of control the spin of the ball as well as the strength. And one of the goals when you're trying to catch the Pokemon is hit that target.That appears.
Ratta が今。
There we go. Got it. Switched over to a different device. It's a Rattata here.
Here's Rattata.
Wii の上に。Wii のところいますけども、この的がこう小さくなった時に、なるべく当てると、まあ捕まえやすいと。
So if you actually try and time it correctly, so that circle in the middle gets small when the ball hits the Pokemon, it'll increase your chances of catching it.
それで今回やっぱりこういろんな方向とか力によってこうボールが飛んでいくのが違うんですね。
And so you're directly controlling the ball. You can control the direction it goes in, the strength.
それが結構やっぱり今までの 3DS だと A ボタンでボール投げてたと思うんですけど、いろんなやり方で。
So in the 3DS games, you just press the A button to catch or throw out a Pokeball. But in this one, you have more direct control over it.
よ。Yes.
Got it.
Gotcha. こういう感じでですね、まあ、このやっぱりこう投げるところはすごいこだわって作ってるんですけど、ちょっとまだまだ改良したくてですね、これ3回ぐらい作ってるんですけど、もう1回作り直そうかなと思って。
So really getting this feel of the throwing the Pokeball out and catching the Pokemon, where I've been putting my effort into, and I've had the folks at Niantic kind of recreate this mechanic even 3 times already, but I'll probably have to do some more improvements again.
We'll do our best.
Now, Masuda-san, are you also working on the music in the game? Because I've noticed that the music is very vibrant and has kind of a lot of action to it.
そうですね。今回の音楽もすごいこうエネルギーあふれる感じなんですけど、マサさんも関わってるんでしょうか。そうですね。今回全部効果音も音楽も全部作っています。自分が作ってます。
So yeah, I'm working on all the sound effects and the music in the game.
で、今回やっぱりその歩いて移動していくっていうゲームなので、まあ、この移動してる感じとか、あとはテンポにすごいこだわっています。
So I'm really, since this is a game where you go out and about and you're walking around while playing it, I wanted the music to be more kind of a higher tempo, higher pace, to really get people excited.
ちょっとこう早めのテンポにすることで、まあ、皆さん歩く速度が少し上がると思うんですけど、早く歩く方が健康的らしいので、いろいろ調べてちょっと早めにしてます。
So, some of the research I've done indicates that walking fast is actually better for your health. So I really wanted to make this music kind of encourage people to, you know, take steps a little bit more quickly and walk faster.
That's very nice.
いいですね。
Now, of course, while you're playing Pokemon Go, at least during the field test, I spend a lot of time looking at my phone as I'm walking and exploring the world and trying to find Pokemon out in the real world. And I have to thank Nomura-san. There's actually this green space near my house where our neighbors have been building trails for a long time. And the trails have actually appeared on the map, and there's Pokestops in the forest, and it's really fun to go in there and search for Pokemon. But one of the things that obviously I think we want to talk a little bit about is sort of our next key topic or key phrase, which is Pokemon Go Plus, which I think makes the game a little bit more handy when you are walking around and trying to catch Pokemon. So, Mr. Miyamoto, can you show it off and tell us a little bit about it?
そうですね。まず宮本さんにちょっと Go Plus についてちょっと話してもらえますか。
そうですね。やっとできました。動いてますよね、ピカピカ。このランプと振動でね、いろんなことが分かるんですけどね。
So actually, here's the device. And you can actually know what's going on based on the light here.
で、これがスマートフォンにつながります。Android でも iPhone でもつながります。ですから、これがあると画面を 見ないでこう歩きながらゲームをすることもできるんですね。
And so with the light and vibration, it tells you what's going on in the smartphone, and it connects via Bluetooth to Android and iPhone, and it basically allows you to play the game without having to look at your smartphone.
Oh, okay. And so how does it work?
まあそれがあると、まあどんなことができるんですか、具体的に。
そうですね。まあ基本は本当にまず目と言いますかね、視覚を解放して。まあ、プレイヤーはこう散歩を楽しむこととこうゲームを楽しむことの融合を図るということがすごく大事だと思っています。
So as I said, you can access certain gameplay functionality without having to look at the smartphone. And what that does, it frees up the player's eyesight in a lot of situations so they can kind of enjoy exploring their surroundings, going for a walk while also playing the game.
まあ、これは本当にNiantic のコンセプトにも見合ってると思いますけど、どうですか？
I think it's part of the philosophy at Niantic, though. Maybe Tatsuo can say something more about that.
Yeah, so at Niantic, our core mission is adventures on foot. So we want people to go outside to discover things, to look around, not looking at your phone. So that's been our challenge and focus. And I think Pokemon Go Plus gives us one answer for that.
まあそうですね、ナイアンティックではその、まあ、外に出てこう冒険するっていうすごい哲学もあるので、なんていうんですかね、そういう、まあ、それが今回のポケモン GO プラスがもうその一つの答えなんじゃないかなというふうに思います。
まあ、ヘッズアッププレイっていうことを言われてまして、まあ、目を上に向けて、そして、ゲームをしようということですね。
はい。Yeah, I think another one I've heard is that you guys call it heads up play to kind of keep your head up and aware of your surroundings while playing the game.
Absolutely.
使い方はですね、ポケモンが出現するとこの、取れますかね、この緑色に点灯しまして、でこの時に振動を感じて、あ、ポケモンが出たってわかるんですね。
So when a Pokemon's nearby, the device will start flashing green like that, and also vibrate, notifying you that, oh, there's a chance to catch a Pokemon.
でその時に、ボタンを押すと、
you can press the button.
この、白いキャプチャーしたっていう判定が出ます。
So you can press the button to throw out a Pokeball, and that'll then decide if we can catch it or not.
その時にうまくポケモンが捕まえられると、この先ほど宮本さんが見せてくれたレインボーに光ってポケモンが gacha ってなるわけですね。
And if you actually end up successfully catching that Pokemon, it'll start flashing in this rainbow color, kind of like what just appeared on Mr. Miyamoto's device.
はい。で、あの、残念ながら失敗することもあって、時々赤いランプがつきます。
It's not a guaranteed success, so if it flashes red, that means that you didn't successfully catch it.
まあ、それ以外にも、あの、フィールド上でいろんなアイテムをゲットできたりとか、まあ、とても便利なツールだと思います。
And there's also a lot of opportunities in the game to get items, but you can catch or you can grab them via the Pokemon Go device, so it's very useful.
まあ、私のフィールドテストにはもう欠かせない必須アイテムに今なってますけれども。
So the Pokemon Go Plus has really turned into a must-have item for me when I'm on my field testing experiences.
ただ、あの、こうやってつけている風に僕はプレイしたいんですけど、今ちょっとそれはできないので、こう手で隠すようにこうやっていつもプレイしています。
So I, whenever I'm taking a walk, I'd rather put it, you know, on my pocket here, but since you know we still haven't released it, I'm always trying to hide it in my hand when I'm taking a walk.
こんな感じでこう。
Being very suspicious.
しかもあれですね、犬のリードを持って、
そうなんです。こっちに
余計にこの方がいいですよね。
そうなんです。
Plus when you have to hold a leash. はい。
犬のリードと犬のうんちと、
うんちと、
あ、そうは関係ない。
Josh and Aaron, did you have any questions about Pokemon Go Plus?
Well, yeah, I have a running loop that's right next to my house, and I would love to be able to run it and play Pokemon Go at the same time. Just playing Pokemon Go on the phone, I see there's Pokestops around the whole thing. I'd love to collect the items, but that means I have to stop my runs. I'm excited to be able to play while still maybe being a little bit more active. So I'm just excited for the device. I guess if I had a question, it would be when will we be able to see Pokemon Go Plus?
そうですね。あの、まあ、家の周り走ったりするんですけども、ポケストップも多くて、やっぱこう走ってるとこういちいち止まってポケストップやってみたいっていうのは、ちょっとまあ面倒くさい感じもあるので、やっぱポケモン Go Plus があるとすごくそれがまあはかどるんじゃないかなと思うんですけれども、まずまあ気になるのはこう、いつ頃、手に入るんでしょうかこのデバイス。
そうですね。あの。7月の、ね、終わりぐらいまでには何とかしたいと思ってるんですけど、さっきの話聞いたと大丈夫ですか
So we actually want to get it out towards the end of July, but listening to just the conversation earlier, we're going to be okay, right?
もう来月ですよ。
That's next month.
Next month, July!
Wow. So we're talking about Pokemon Go Plus, right?
Yeah. あれですよね、あのアプリじゃなくて Go Plus のデバイス。
いや。
じゃあ先にこれだけ買ってください。
So we're gonna get this first.
Yeah, I also wanted to ask. I've been using Pokemon Go basically every day on my way to work. And in New York City, everyone's very, very busy. So I'll be in the middle of the street trying to catch a Pokemon. Everyone will look at me and tell me to get out of the way. And so I'm very excited for Pokemon Go Plus. And I wanted to know, when it does get released, where can I and everyone else go purchase an actual version of it?
ニューヨークでやってる時も結構やっぱいちいち止まって、これボール投げしてると結構やっぱ通行人多いので、こう怪しそうな感じになって、Go Plus があるといいなってすごく思ってるんですけれども、ですね、どういうところで買えるんでしょうか。
あ、これはですね、やはりせっかく、まあ、スマホで遊んでいるときにそのスマホからその直接、購入できた方がいいなと思っています。ですから、ゲームの中で、最も、その地域に近い、ところから、まあ、買えるような、まあ、そういう仕組み。でもう一つはもちろん店頭でも、買えるようにしたいと思っています。
This is kind of another new thing for us to do, but obviously it's kind of like what you're saying. You'll probably want the device the most when you're playing the game. So what we decided to do is have a button from within the application that'll direct you to the appropriate store for your region to purchase the device online. And it'll also be available in certain physical retailers as well.
So, Mr. Miyamoto, since you kind of surprised us and shared our release timing, do you also want to surprise us and share the price as well?
そうですね。そうですね。$34.99。
It'll be $34.99.
どうですか?
Is that all right?
Well, I guess if Pokemon Go Plus is coming out relatively soon, we can have some hopes for Pokemon Go coming out soon. So with Pokemon Go launching in the near future and Pokemon Sun and Moon coming later this year, I'm wondering, Mr. Masuda, Are you planning any connection between Pokemon Go and Pokemon Sun and Moon?
まあ Go Plus が、まあ、7月末、っていう話になって、まあ、アプリも、まあ、すぐに出るんじゃないかなというふうにはちょっと思うんですけれども、まあ同時にあのサンムーンの開発も進んでいて今年年末に出るという、ことだと思うんですけれども、はい、何かこうこの今年出るゲームのこの2本こうなんかつながりみたいなものっていうのは考えていますか？
そうですね、まあ、もちろんポケモン GO をいっぱい遊んでもらっていっぱい捕まえてもらって、うん、で、まあ、皆さんなんかいろいろ考えてると思うんですけど、まあ、自分たちもやっぱりサンとムーンとやっぱ関係性を持たせたいなと思ってますんで、まあ、何か、やってみたいなと。
So when the game first comes out, we really want people just to focus on going out, having you know, real life adventures and catching Pokemon. But eventually, at some point, we do plan to add some kind of connectivity between Pokemon Go and the main games.
I'm very excited to hear that.
That'll be fun.
Yeah. Any comments from the two of you on that or questions?
Well, I guess in general, I'm just really excited hearing all of this functionality, all these different plans coming for Pokemon Go.I've noticed we've already even been getting new features in the field test that we've been messing with as well. I saw there's now ways to power up and evolve your Pokemon. I guess my question would be, how does that system work? I've seen like Pokemon Candy, and it's different than what I'm used to, and I would love to hear more about it.
最近ちょっとフィールドテストに追加する、された機能として、ポケモンをこう強化させるとか進化させるというものがあるんですけれども、それってもうちょっと詳しく話してもらっていいですか？
そうですね、まあ、ポケモンの魅力は、まあ、なんといってもこうやって進化させたりポケモンを、まあ、レベルを上げて強くしたりということだと思いますので、まあ、今回の中でその仕組みを入れました。ただ、まあスマホらしい新しい仕組みでの、進化の仕方や、強くさせ方を、まあ作ってみました。
But when it comes to this kind of powering up mechanism, we wanted to do something new for the smartphone device format, so we've come up with a different system.
何か野村さんの方で付け加えることありますか？
Yeah, so just like what Ishihara-san said, because this is a smartphone device game, it's very different. We expect people to play this when they're outside. So instead of like the, in the core series where you battle Pokemon to catch, to level up,That will actually take a lot of time. We don't want people to stop. We want people to, you know, walk a bit and catch a Pokemon and keep moving. So we invented this new system, just what you said, the candies. So you, every time you catch a Pokemon, you get a few candies. And by collecting these candies, you can use them to power up or evolve your Pokemon. For example, if you catch 25, it's 25 Squirtle, and you get 25 Squirtles candy. Now, if you use that, you can evolve Squirtle to a War Turtle.
I hope I find more, because I picked Squirtle to start.
We're still tuning and adjusting the details and the names, so that's the, as much details as I can give out.
Okay.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, another question I actually had is, you know, one of the staple components of Pokemon, the core Pokemon series, is the ability to trade with other people. We saw in the trailer for Pokemon Go that was released a few months ago, a bunch of players trading inside Pokemon Go. But when I was playing the field test, I saw that trading hadn't been implemented yet. So I wanted to ask, you know, will that eventually be implemented?
やっぱポケモンといえばもう交換というのが結構強い要素としてあると思うんですけれども、まあ、最初 の, その発表の時の映像ではまあ交換しているシーンもあったんですけども、まだフィールドテストにはちょっと実装されていないと思いますが、予
定ありますか？現在はもちろんこの交換はこれからちゃんとできるようにするんですけれども、まずは最初はできるだけたくさんのポケモンをみんなに集めていただきたいと。でその集めてだんだんこう交換がしたくなった頃にこの機能を足していくというか入れていくという形にしたいと思っています。
Yeah, so of course we have plans to implement it as was shown in the video, but at the first, when we first launched the game, we really want people again to kind of focus on going out, catching a lot of Pokemon. So we'll find the appropriate timing once people have maybe caught quite a few Pokemon and they're starting to really want to trade with other people to get more, we'll implement the trading function then.
まあ、スマホのゲームは、まあ、最初はできるだけ入り口が広くて遊びやすくてシンプルなものにして、それでだんだんだんだん濃いユーザーが増えてきたら、こう機能を順次増やしていきたいというふうに考えています。
And this kind of goes back to my philosophy of developing smartphone games, where you kind of really bring out the core experience when you first launch the application. Then as people, you know, stick with it and they want more kind of depth of gameplay, we add on more functionality, new features and everything to really keep people interested.
Okay.That makes a lot of sense. That actually kind of leads me into my next question. I also wanted to ask a little bit about, it's also regards the trailer we saw earlier. I remember one of the most exciting scenes that came out from that trailer were a lot of people gathered in Times Square in New York trying to catch a Mewtwo and working together. And I remember I was really freaking out. I thought it was awesome. And I wanted to ask, you know, does Pokemon Go eventually have plans where players can work together and, you know, work on catching Pokemon together or group activities?
まあ、もう一つちょっとあれですね、発表の時の映像からの質問になるんですけれども、すごい最後の方にまあ、たくさんの人が集まってミュウツーをこう一緒に捕まえるというシーンがあったんですけれども、そのようなこういっぱい人が集まってこう協力するみたいなゲームプレイというのは入れる予定ありますか？
はい、このイベントはね、これからどんどん入れていきたいと思っています。ただ今の段階でグループでジムを攻略するという仕組みも入っていると思いますので、まずは小さい人数のグループでいろんなジムを攻略するという遊びから始めてもらいたいと思います。
So we've already got some gameplay in the field test version where you can kind of get groups of players together to go and attack or take down gyms. So that's kind of a hint of what's to come maybe.
でそれの後にきっとこれからどんどんいろんなイベントが始まると思いますので、楽しみにしていてください。
Yeah, I think we definitely got a lot of cool plans for what we want to do with bigger events, so I hope you'll look forward to it.
Awesome.
It's very exciting to hear about the events and the gyms. I've had some challenges trying to defeat some of the gyms in my neighborhood because I got started a little bit late in the field testing. But it also, you know, all of the real world gaming talk reminds me of some of the projects that Mr. Miyamoto has worked on in the past with things like the Louvre Guide and even Street Pass on Nintendo 3DS. And I was kind of curious, Mr. Miyamoto, if this ties into any other projects you might be thinking about or any of your past projects that you've worked on?
ビルさんはフィールドテスト入ったのがちょっと遅めで、まあ、そうですね、結構周りにもう強いジムが出来上がっててなかなか攻略できないんですけれども、まあ、それをちょっと置いておいて、結構任天堂さんの方で、まあ、任天堂の方でも、結構そういう位置情報とか、まあ、ゲームとかを関連付けたものっていうのは、まあ、いくつかチャレンジはしてきてるんですけれども、例えば宮本さんが関わってルーブル美術館の、ガイドのアプリとかなんですけれども、まあ、今回、ちょっと宮本さんに聞きたいんですけれども、そのポケモン GO、まあ、GO プラスにこの取り組みについて、どうお考えですか？
そうですね、DS の頃からね、ずっと、まあ、もっと GBA の頃からGPS を使って何かというか、いろんな実験をしてきたんですけど、なかなか精度とかいろんなものがうまくいかなかった。でルーブルはまた別の仕組みで実現したんですけども、それは今度ナイアンティックさんの技術とこのポケモン GO で本当にいろんなところみんなが集まって遊ぶとか、いろんなところに行って遊ぶことができるようになったので、非常に幸せに思ってます。やっぱりこういうこのデバイスは初めてスマートフォンにつながるデバイスなんですけど、まあ、この技術とこのこういうデバイスがあるとまだまだいろんな遊びにこれから展開できるなと思うんですけども、楽しみにしてます。
So you know, games based on location information is something that Nintendo worked on in the DS and even as early as the GBA, but we weren't able to really put into effect because we weren't able to get some good data. But you know, with this device we can get actual GPS location data that's really we can use this to really expand gameplay.And, you know, like for in the Louvre Museum guy that you mentioned, that's using a different sort of spec, so it's a little different. But, you know, this device is something that connects to a smartphone, which is the first time for something Nintendo related that doesn't connect to a Nintendo platform. And I think this will provide us with also with the technology from Niantic. It'll provide us, it kind of expands our horizon into what kinds of different gameplay we can do. So I'm very happy to see this taking off.
Well, I could probably talk about Pokemon Go all morning, but I'm sure we've got folks that want to see some other things. So I wanted to take a moment and thank everybody for joining us on stage and give you each an opportunity to deliver maybe one last message to our viewers.
まあどんどん話したい内容はまだ山ほどあるんですけれども、もうちょっと時間が来ましたので、まあ最後にちょっと皆さん一人一人からちょっとご最後のメッセージということで、何か話してもらえますか。じゃあまず石原さんから
そうですね。
はい。 まあ、先ほど宮本さんの方から、ポケモン GO プラスの発売日が発表されてしまいましたので、ポケモン GO はさらにそれより前にないといけないということですので、みんなで頑張って、ね、間に合わせたいと思いますけど。
I think you just announced the release date for the Pokemon Go Plus device, and obviously that means we've got to have the application out there ahead of time, so we're going to have to work hard to get it ready for everyone.
でもぜひ面白いゲームになっていると思うんで楽しみに待っててほしいと思います。
I think it's really coming together to be a really interesting game for everyone, so I hope people look forward to it.
はい、まあ、この位置情報ゲームなので地球上の至る所にポケモンが現れますので、いろんなところに行ってみたり、まあ、旅してみたり旅先で、まあ、プレイしてみたりっていうんですね、まあ、いろんな楽しみ方があると思うんで、まあ、そうやってポケモントレーナーたちがどんどん増えていくっていうのを楽しみにしています。
Pokemon are going to appear in the real world. So when you're out, you know, in your neighborhood, or even when you're, for example, you know, you're on a vacation, you're somewhere new, you're going to be able to encounter all these Pokemon, be a real Pokemon trainer yourself. So I hope people really look forward to that aspect. A lot of fun packed in the game. じゃあ、Tatsuo, you want to say?
Yeah, sure. So at Niantic, we value, so we started this real world gaming with Ingress.And what we are trying to do to achieve is actually more than just a game. We're trying to bring people outside, want people to discover interesting places like around their neighborhood or like when the new places they visit. So that's something we're trying really hard to achieve. And with this Pokemon game, so you can go capture a lot of different Pokemon in different area, but the fun is actually outside. It's not only in the screen. You look outside, you'll find interesting things and people around you. That's really important to us. The team has been working really hard with the help from the community to try to develop the game to... We didn't really announce the launch date yet, I think. but we're really... right now, at this moment, the team is working to make the game. So please look forward to...
You've got to go back after this.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I got to start working right after this. Right, yeah.
じゃあ、すみません。宮本さんからお
願いします。We are ready now. 本当にね、任天堂ポケモンも含めて幅広い人に遊んでほしいと思ってます。で、これ、お父さんのスマートフォンにつないで、子供が一緒に歩きながら遊ぶこともできますし、ぜひとも皆さんで楽しんでいただけるかと思います。
Including Pokemon, we want a very wide variety of people to enjoy our games. So this is, can actually be connected to, say, your parents' smartphone, and you can play together. So I really want to encourage everybody to play together and have fun.
Well, I've been having a lot of fun. I'm going to keep walking and hunting until I find my favorite Pokemon, Psyduck. So hopefully we can find some find Psyduck soon.
That's better.
Uh-oh. But again, did you two have anything you wanted to add? Or?
Yeah, so I've been playing Pokemon since the first game, Red and Blue, or for you guys, Red and Green. and I've played every game, every side game. I really love, I guess, throwing myself into this Pokemon universe. But never have I played a Pokemon game and gotten to see it as it was being developed. This has been a really unique opportunity.And I just want to thank you all so much for having us as a part of this and letting us I guess, be with so many incredible Nintendo, Pokemon, Niantic All-Stars who've been developing some of my favorite games forever.
Yeah, Josh put that really well. But I've also you know, been a huge Pokemon fan. And I've played basically every Pokemon game, whether it's part of the original series or a spin-off. Mm-hmm. And,Pokemon Go is one of the most unique games that I've ever seen, not just inside Pokemon, but outside of Pokemon as well. I have a lot of friends back at home who might have stopped playing Pokemon a little bit earlier on, but are really excited to continue playing Pokemon through Pokemon Go. And I attend the competitive Pokemon video game tournaments, and those are great experiences. And I think Pokemon Go will further enhance everyone's experience there and really bring everyone together. So thank you to Niantic and Pokemon for having me here, and I'm really excited to see the future of it.
Well,
Ishihara-san, Masuda-san, Nomura-san, Miyamoto-san, thank you very much for joining us today. Everybody watching at home, we have more Nintendo Treehouse Live coming up. We've got a full day of new content that we haven't shown you yet here at E3. It's going to start off with the introduction of a brand new IP that's going to blend some action with some RPG coming to Nintendo 3DS. And we have a special guest developer for that segment as well. So stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few moments. Thank you, everybody.